Welcome to Unlock Layouts. In this video lecture, we are going to discuss how to do the deep and well diode extraction in the layout and how to add the manual guarding for the deep and well and how to update the deep and well diode related informations in the schematic and how the LVS tool is extracting this parasitic diode formation of deep and well and it is going to compare between the schematic and the layout. So this video lecture will be a lengthier one, so I'll make it into multiple parts. So we will discuss each important information in the each individual parts. Let's start the video. In this schematic, we have a two different devices. These devices are NMOSFET devices. Source and gate and drain is connected to a same network. And then whereas your substrate is connecting to a different connection. So the two different MOSFETs are M0 and M3. It is connected in the different substrate connection. So in this condition, since it is a NMOSFET device, the substrate of the NMOSFET devices is not connected to a common ground in the same level of layout. It is connecting to a different body connection. We need a deep and well in this case. So in depth of deep and well, we have already discussed in our previous videos. If you have any doubts in the deep and well, you can just refer those videos. It is already available in our YouTube channel. Now in this video, what we are going to see, how to add deep and well ring in case if the deep and well ring is not available in your PDK or in your library. So manually how to add a deep and well ring and how to extract those deep and well ring from the schematic to layout and layout to schematic. So vice versa, we need to, you know, we can export the diode extraction. And then how your LVS tool is extracting the diode, how it is exactly finding that whether the diode is forming between some junction, okay, in some layout. So how the tool is actually working. So all those things we are going to discuss in this video lecture. So I can make this video into a different part because a single part, it's very, it will be a lengthy lecture. So we cannot complete this in the single part. So I'll make it maybe two or three parts in the consecutive videos. We'll try to finish it. So now in general, I'm just trying to extract the device from the schematic actually. So now those devices are extracted, M0 and M3. So these are all NMOSFET devices. Only NMOSFET devices, we need a deep and well, whereas PMOSFET device, we don't want a deep and well. Okay, now these are all two devices. See, generally what we will do, we'll add a guard ring for the devices. But since these devices are having its own substrate connection, we need to add a different type of deep and well guard ring for each devices. Okay, it's not a common guard ring. We need to add a deep and well guard ring. Okay, so we know how to add the guard ring in general. We have a shortcut Shift G. We can go to the tool and we will add the guard ring. But in case if you try to add guard ring by using Shift G, you will find only two guard rings here. Like whereas we will find N well guard ring, whereas we will find the P substrate guard ring. So there is no dedicated guard ring available for deep N well. Okay, so what happened? This is the problem related to PDK because in general, there are few companies, they will customize their own template, they will create the guard ring. But in the generic PDK, in the generic PDKs, they don't get, you know, they don't provide foundry, they don't provide the dedicated guard ring for the deep and well. We need to manually request for the template. Since it is not available, what we can do, we can manually create those template by ourselves. But again, it's a very little complex process for our layout engineers. So instead of that, we can simply, we have another option to add, you know, these guard rings actually. So what we can do, first of all, it's a NMOSFET device. We need to add a P substrate guard ring, right? So I'll keep these two devices side by side with some distance. First, I'll select these devices, one device. I'll go to Shift G. So what guard ring we need to add? It's an NMOSFET device. We need to add the P substrate guard ring. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to add the P substrate guard ring here with the enclosure of 0.5. See, this enclosure is completely customizable number. Okay, you can keep as per your own wish. Just for simplicity, I kept 0.5 here. Okay, I added 0.5. Then again, I'm going to select another device. This device also, I'm going to add the same guard ring with the enclosures of 0.5. So now I have added two different guard ring for these devices. Okay, one device is already having another guard ring. Another device is also added the individual guard ring. So now, since we know we need to add the deep and well, what we need to do, again, we need to select the same device. Again, you have to go for Shift G, add NVL guard ring in this case now. So make it NVL guard ring with the enclosures of same 0.5 for this device. Again, select this device also. Again, same the add NVL guard ring for in this another device also with the enclosures of 0.5. Okay, so now both the devices are added. PVL guard ring and as well as NVL guard ring. So now if you do the parasitic extraction in your LSW window, so the tool will identify first there is a guard ring. So it's a P-type guard ring. So it's a P-junction. Again, there is a N-type guard ring. So this is the N-junction. So P and N-junction, combination of the P and N acting as a P-N-junction. So it's another diode formation. Okay. So this is how in the layout we need to add deep and well guard ring. But here still we are missing something, that is our deep and well layer. Because here we have a N-well, we have a P-well, but we don't have a dedicated deep and well layer actually. So what we need to do, you have to go to the LSW window, try to find out DNW. By typing DNW, you will find the layer here, deep and well layer. Okay, select this deep and well layer, come to your device, press rectangular option just by clicking R in the rectangular. You can manually draw a deep and well completely enclosed by your N-well, because deep and well take power supply through N-well. Okay, you cannot directly inject power to deep and well. Through N-well only we need to inject power to the deep and well. If you refer the cross-sectional view of the deep and well diagram, maybe you'll understand these options. Okay, you'll understand this concept. But in layout we need to add the deep and well layer manually. It should be exactly overlap your N-well. See, you cannot you are not supposed to draw a deep and well like this, like by keeping a small N-well enclosure between the deep and well to N-well. It has to be exactly cover your deep and well to N-well. It should not come outside of your N-well, or it should not be inside of your N-well. It should be exactly overlap your N-well in such a way that we need to add your deep and well layer here. So now these two devices we added, first of all we added P substrate guard ring, then we added N substrate guard ring, then again manually we added our deep and well guard ring. So now in this structure acting as a deep and well diode formation. Okay, this is how we need to create our deep and well layer, deep and well guard ring, in case if the deep and well ring is not available, if in case the template is not available in your guard ring option. Okay, fine. We'll check out what other DRCs we are getting in this case. First of all, we'll get a common DRC. Like deep and well to deep and well, we need to at least maintain 3.5 micrometer of distance. That is a general DRC. Other than that, just see what other DRCs we are getting here. Yeah, we got our DRC results. Yes, as we discussed, like here, deep and well to deep and well spacing should be greater than 3.5. So it has to be here because we have two different deep and well here. So these two deep and well has to be separated by 3.5 micrometer. See, these deep and well and this deep and well, at least we need to maintain 3.5 micrometer. Then again, there is another spacing DRC. I think this is also the same spacing DRC between deep and well to N well. Okay, so again, there is another deep and well spacing issue, yes, 0.5. Okay, this we'll discuss later. Okay, first we need to resolve the first DRC. Deep and well to deep and well should be greater than 3.5 micrometer. Okay, first I'll select all the device, one side device. Okay, I'll select this device. I'll make an alignment of 3.5 micrometer. Okay, I'll make a user spacing. I'll make it a 3.5 between N-well, deep and well to deep and well. I'll zoom it here. Yeah, deep and well layer to another deep and well layer. Yes, now it is 3.5 micrometer. Yeah, one DRC is clear. Okay, then we'll look out another DRC here. See, there is another DRC. This is very important DRC actually. So in this DRC window, there is something called deep and well spacing here. So what it is showing here, if there is a deep and well layer which is interacting with different potential, because here the tool doesn't know what VSS RF is taking and what VSS substrate is connected to, whether it's a zero potential or a different potential, because the tool exactly doesn't know what kind of potential it is going to connect. So now the tool is telling that if there is a two different devices with a different potential, this N-well should be greater than 1 micrometer. Okay, which N-well? So here we have a N-well, right? So this N-well layer, where it is exactly located here, this width of the anvil should be minimum 0.1 to greater than 0.1. So what we can do to resolve this issue, you can select the guard ring here. First select the guard ring, press Q, then you will get the properties of the guard ring. So in this properties of guard ring, just go to the subpart. Okay, there is option called subpart. Select subpart here. Then again, you will get another window here. Okay, so you will get another window here, subpart window. Just bring this subpart window here. In this subpart window, select your anvil layer. Then go to this enclosure. Make it 0.45. Maybe I think 0.45, only 45. This value 45, I know exactly if I type 45, this will increase up to 1 micrometer because I'm working in this PDK for a longer period of time. So I know what number, this 45. What is the reason here I'm keeping the 45? Because I did a lot of trial and error and find out the answers. It depends on the PDK, this numbers may change. Okay. So now I just type 45 here. Then I am going to edit my anvil layer here. Okay, select your anvil and edit this anvil and click OK. Then again click apply, then OK. See, now here previously our anvil is very small. Now the anvil area is extended here from here to here. From here to here, it is extended 1 micrometer. That means the anvil width of the anvil I have increased up to 1 micrometer. Okay, so previously it was 0.24. Now I increased into 1 micrometer. So again, I need to do the same thing here in the another side also. Select this guard ring, go to the property, go to the subpart. Okay, select your anvil layer. Again, enclosure here, it is 0.7 actually. Make it 45. Okay, make it 45. And then just edit and click OK. And then click apply. That's all. So now we extended the anvil layer 1 micrometer away. Okay, so that is exactly 1 micrometer. So again, what we need to do? We need to extend this deep anvil guard ring because as we discussed in the earlier scenario, deep anvil should be exactly overlap your anvil. Now, anvil is somewhere away from your deep anvil. Your deep anvil is inside your anvil. So this is not acceptable. Again, we'll get a lot of different kind of parasitic extractions here. So what we need to do, select this deep anvil layer, first of all, okay? So make it a proper alignment of this deep anvil. That is more enough, okay? Make it here and then align it here. And then make it here and then keep align your anvil here. Okay, so one side we have aligned, then go for stretch option. Select your layer of your deep anvil, then you can stretch this deep anvil somewhere here from here. Yes, you can stretch it exactly here. Yeah, so same way all the side, both bottom, left and top and right, it has to be exactly cover. Okay, so now the same deep anvil, I'm going to select it here and just make a copy and I'll keep it here. That's all. Because anyway, deep anvil is common. I'll just copy and paste the deep anvil in order to save the time. Again, we know that deep anvil to deep anvil spacing should be 3.5 micrometer. So at present, the violations, DRC violations will be there here because we have changed the parameters. So see, the deep anvil to deep anvil is not exactly 3.5. So again, we need to make a proper alignment of that. So make a number and user spacing of 0.35 micrometer, exactly 3.5 micrometer. Okay, select your deep anvil layer. Again, this deep anvil layer. Okay, both the deep anvil layer, you can select it. Yeah, now both the deep anvils are away 3.5 micrometer. Okay, so then now save the layout. Then again, just we will ensure that whether is there any DRC present or not. I'll give another DRC check here. I think all the DRCs are almost clear. So still we have another DRC. So what is this DRC here? Yeah, so I know what is this DRC. So this DRC, it's giving the information. If there is a P substrate layer, okay, let me highlight that. Maybe you can understand very easily. I'll highlight this DRC because all those DRCs are simple DRC. See here, what happened? When there is a P well P strap, okay, it is a P well guard ring. Okay, when there is a P well guard ring OD, it has to be away from the anvil 0.65 micrometer. That is another DRC. Okay, it's a common DRC. So now it extended 0.5, but it has to be at least 0.65. That's the DRC. See, there is a OD of your P well guard ring. It has to be away from the anvil, at least should be greater than 0.65. So what I can do, I can select this guard ring. I'll delete this guard ring because again, changing the guard ring value will take additional time for me. I'll select the device. Again, I'll go to Shift G. I'll create a new guard ring. Okay, instead of anvil guard ring, I'll select a P substrate guard ring here. Okay, I'll select P substrate guard ring. I'll select P substrate guard ring here. Instead of keeping 0.5 enclosure, I'll make the enclosures of 0.15. 0.15 is the minimum number. Okay, so then click hide. Then the same thing we have to do opposite side also, because here also we have the same problem. Delete this guard ring, select the device, again go to Shift G. So we need to change the guard ring to P substrate guard ring. Enclosure should be 0.5. Click apply and hide. Yeah, now it is okay. So two guard rings are already added. So just I'll align the devices properly. So only you will get some minimum DRC. It is not very difficult or very complex DRC. Simple DRC, since we don't have any default guard ring, we can use this manual guard ring. So now all those things are density DRC. So these are all OD density, another poly density, matching warning density, then whatever you are getting, all these things are exceptional DRC. So we can clear these DRCs in the top level, but we don't have any base level DRCs in this case. So now our layout is exactly added a deep envelope guard ring, since there is no deep envelope available in our library, but we have added deep envelope layer here. Okay. So now we understood that in case in our PDK, if there is no deep envelope template is available, deep envelope guard ring template is available, how to manually add a deep envelope guard ring and how to clear the DRC with respect to the deep envelope guard ring. Okay. Then in the next part, we will discuss how the tool is extracting the parasitic diode from the schematic to layout, and as well the layout to schematic, vice versa. Okay, so we will discuss those things in our part 2 video.
I hope I have given some valuable information to you in this video. Thank you for watching my video. If you like this video, please click like button and share this video to your friends. For more details about this video, please contact us to my email ID and follow us on my Facebook page and Twitter page, and kindly subscribe our channel and don't forget to click the bell button.